هي الحلقات تحفظني بآيات من القرآن، هي الحلقات تملأني بحب المصطفى العدنان، هي الحلقات تحفظني بآيات من القرآن.
The Quran guides us to the paradise. What is paradise? Apartments surrounded by the gardens, beneath which the rivers flow. Similarly, Allah Almighty has described stories. Story of Adam and Iblis, Satan and Adam. Then story of Noah alayhi salam. Story of Lot, Lut alayhi salam. Story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then story of Yusuf alayhi salam, Joseph, and story of Moses. And all these stories, except the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, have been repeatedly described in the Quran, mentioned in the Quran. What is the objective? Objective is guidance. Each and every story is a lesson for me and you all. And Allah Almighty knows how many times this lesson is to be reminded. And in the same ratio, in the same proportion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described that story to us. And how should a slave be to Allah? This, the role model for that is Ibrahim alayhi salam. The level that he has touched in pursuit of Allah's slavery, no one can ever reach there. And it's only the Prophet who is innocent, who is masoom, who doesn't make mistake. Since we are ordinary human beings, we are bound to make errors. We are likely to make mistakes every now and then. And the Quran described, فَلَمَّا ذَاقَ شَجَرَةَ. No sooner did they taste from it, بَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. Their privates got exposed to each other. How to draw guidance from the Quran? If you read the translation, that is not the Quran. They are human words. Close to the text of the Quran, you can say, yet not divine words. Similarly, if you read the tafsir, if you read the papers on the Quran and books on the Quran, none of them is Quran. The guidance of the Quran is in its recitation. So the whole life of Ibrahim alayhi salam is a symbol of Allah's slavery, symbol of Allah's worship, and symbol of Allah's love, symbol of Allah's submission. No doubt, when you recite from the Quran, you get virtues added to your account for each and every letter of the Quran. But it is a byproduct of the recitation. The revelation of the Quran is for guidance. So one has to recite from the Quran regularly in pursuit of guidance. Then Allah Almighty will guide him. Satan didn't admit that he made a mistake. Whereas Adam and Eve simply confessed, oh, we were wrong. Oh, we are sorry. Please forgive us. So this is the attitude which Allah Almighty asks us to live in this life with. This is the story of Nuh alayhi salam, Noah. He was the symbol of Dawah. You know, normally we make some Dawah work, invite certain people again and again, but they don't listen, they don't pay attention, they don't obey. We get fed up. Oh, they're not interested. Why should we ask them again and again and again and again? But symbol of Dawah, the role model of Dawah in the Holy Quran is Nuh alayhi salam. He did Dawah work. He called his people to Allah. to the hereafter and believe in Him as Allah's messenger. Not only once, not for a week, not for a month, not for a year. 950 years He went on calling them, went on calling them, kept on calling them. Whereas no one was ready to even listen to Him. They were pushing their fingers into their ears. We don't want to listen to you. They were pulling their rugs on it. We don't want to listen. Yet He was again and again. During the day, during the night. In the morning, in the evening. In private, in public. One to one and collective dawah. This is what He was doing. But no one listened to Him at all.
بحب المصطفى العدنان هي الحلقات تحفظني بآيات من القرآن.